Now, this one really hurt, not only for thousands of Habs fans, but Matt Drake over here. I know you've been with us from the start, watching these games, believing in this team every step of the way. How are you feeling right now?
Quite disappointed, you know. I mean, to get this far and to lose, especially on a shutout, unable to generate any kind of offense in this game when they had an opportunity to maybe bring it back to Montreal for one more game, it really sucks. But still, at the same time, you got to be proud of this team, right? Nobody believed in them. Nobody thought they were going to get through the Leafs, especially when they went down 3-1 against the Leafs. A lot of people wrote them off, pretty much everybody. And they battled back, and they swept the Jets. Then they beat a Knights team that everybody thought were basically the heir apparent to the Stanley Cup champions in the Tampa Bay Lightning. And, you know, they beat them in six games, mopped the floor with them, sort of. They did things that nobody thought they were really capable of doing, so we should really just be proud of this team at this point. It's really disappointing to see it end like this, but at the same time, again, gotta have some pride in the fact that they got this far when nobody thought they could.
Absolutely. Now let's talk a little bit more about Carey Price. He obviously helped this team get to this point. What did you think of his performance today?
He played great. I mean, they lost 1-0, right? It could have been a lot worse when you look at the shot totals, the scoring chance totals. Tampa Bay was essentially the better team in almost every metric. But Carey Price kept them in it. He gave them an opportunity. They just couldn't get any run support for him. And even the best goaltender on the planet, which he may still be, it's either him or Vasilevsky. It's between those two. Vasilevsky was fantastic as well. But even the best goaltender on the planet needs run support. And if you don't get it for him, then unfortunately there's not a whole lot you can do.
And speaking of Vasilevsky, he won the MVP, clearly an absolutely incredible, incredible goalie, was able to really show up in these series. You know, what did you think of his performance?
Oh, he was amazing. I mean, I don't know if he took it to heart that this was considered like the battle of the two people that are considered to maybe be the best goaltenders on the planet, but he played like it. He deserved the MVP. You know, if it was the other way around, if the Habs managed to pull off this comeback, for sure Price would have got the MVP. So it was going to be one of those goaltenders the whole time. The fact that we got to see those two at their best playing against each other was definitely something to behold. Unfortunately for the Montreal Canadiens, you know, Vasilevsky was a huge difference maker, especially if you look at that game two, right? Habs had like 43 shots on goal in game two. If they win that game, this series is still going on right now. You know, there's still a game six in Montreal. So big credit to Vasilevsky. I mean, he stepped up and proved that if he's not the best goaltender in the world, he's right up there.
Yeah, absolutely. And what's next for this team? Obviously, they have so many incredible players, some really great youngsters as well. What can we expect from the team from here on out?
I think they're poised for a long time of relevance, right? I don't know if necessarily you could say the cup window's open, but I think there's no reason to say that it's not. The fact that they got this far, that they did it with mostly production from really young players like Nick Suzuki, Cole Caulfield, Jesperi Kotkaniemi. Tyler Toffoli was the second highest scorer on the team in the course of the playoffs, and he's on a four-year contract with the team at a bargain deal. So right now they're set up for a long time of being relevant in the Stanley Cup playoffs. They proved this year that they can do a lot more than anybody gave them credit for, and they did that on the back of really young players, right? Cole Caulfield, it's not even his rookie season. His rookie season is next year because he came in late. So there's reason to believe that this team has opened a cup window and that they can keep that window open for a while. If they have a good offseason, who knows? They could be back here next year and they could be back looking considerably better. And again, we got to be proud of what this team's done this year and hope that, you know, they can replicate that next year and maybe get over that hump that is the Tampa Bay Lightning.
Absolutely. You know, a lot of disappointment here in the city, but I think this brought a lot of hope and a lot of Habs fans together. I think that, you know, both you and I have never witnessed this sort of coming together when it comes to Habs fans. People are disappointed, but extremely thankful that they got to witness this. Unfortunately, not going their way, Tampa hoisting the Stanley Cup, but we're going to have more analysis for you and reactions at the end of the show. In Montreal, Henriques, City News.